Dear Powell, this is your boy Junior writing you to tell you how I've been doing. Well, I've seen a lot of things, but I ain't never seen nothing like what happened to me the other day. I was walking down the road in this place called Lexington in Kentucky, and all of a sudden this big crowd of people come up from behind me, all pushing and a shoving, and before I could fight my way out of it, I had come up in front of the biggest barn in the world. I asked this one feller what it was, and he said, boy, it's Rupp's Arena, like I was ignorant or something for asking. Well, I walked on inside of that barn to see what it was they had all come to see. And in the floor of that barn, they'd set them up a wooden stage. And at each end of that stage, there's a picture window hanging on some metal braces and a basket bolted to the picture window. Well, I was sitting there trying to figure out what kind of show it was they was going to put on there. And the feller said what it was basketball. About that time, this bunch of giants dressed in blue and white come running out of a stall at one end of that barn and are carrying a pumpkin. Well, people took to shouting and a screaming and a jumping up and down, and a feller said that them was the Kentucky Wildcats. And these fellers up in the loft of that barn took to playing music, and the guy behind me tapped me on the shoulder and said, stand up, boy, that's a fight song they are playing. I told him I didn't want no trouble, and I sure as heck wasn't about to fight over no song. I figured out that these Kentucky Wildcat fellers must have gone to some kind of a special school together, because the fellers next to me said that they was in a class of their own. Then these out-of-state fellers come running out of a stall at the other end of that barn, and they was carrying a pumpkin. Before long, they cleared that stage, and these three convicts come out into the middle of it, and they was carrying a pumpkin too. Well, the Kentucky Wildcats and them out-of-state fellers each had picked five fellers to strip down to their undershirts and boxer shorts and went out to the middle of the stage where them convicts was. Well, them convicts was up to no good, because they had took and hit all the pumpkins but one. And they took that one pumpkin and they throwed it up in the air, and that's when the fight started. Kentucky had sent the tallest one that they had, named Sam Bowie, in there to smack that pumpkin out. And I know that he was real important because they had hired them a bunch of strong men as his bodyguards and surrounded him with them. Well, the more I got to watching this basketball thing, I figured out that they wasn't fighting over that pumpkin at all. That what they was trying to do was take it and throw it through them baskets. Well, Kentucky was doing a whole lot better at throwing it through than them out-of-state fellers was. And I mean to tell you that when one of them missed and that pumpkin bounced off that window, they's the awfulest fight that you ever did see for it. And most of the time, Bowie or one of his bodyguards was a-coming out with it. Well, when they get in there and get to scrapping too bad over it, one of them convicts would run in there and bust it up. Then he'd run over to the man what had the microphone and tell him which one had caused the trouble. And then they'd warn him over the loudspeaker. And after what they had warned one of them five times, they'd make him go over there and sit in the corner by himself. Well, I watched Kentucky whoop up on these poor old out-of-state fellers for 40 minutes before it was all over. And I figured out that these out-of-state fellers must have committed some kind of awful crime. And they had to come in there and let Kentucky whoop up on them as their punishment. And they had stationed guards at them doors so them out-of-state fellers couldn't escape until they's done with them. Well, as everybody was a-leaving, I was sitting there trying to figure it all out. And it reminded me of them in them history books and them Colosseums in Rome where them gladiators would come out and do battle. And that's what them Kentucky Wildcats looked like, was big blue gladiators. Well, Pa, I've taken a great liking to this thing they call basketball, and I want you to know that folks up here is real friendly. If I ever get lonesome, I just cut loose with a go big blue, and I always find somebody that's a-willing to talk to me. Well, I guess I'll close now. Signed, yours truly, your boy Junior.